interesting how recently on TV there was a show about dog aggression over food. There are trainers who have years and years of experience, and their methods are scientifically proven. They have there are trainers who have done their PhDs in certain behaviors just to see if it works, and they've tested it over and over again. So what we know today as a fact, that dominance theory is no longer serving us, is no longer serving our dogs. It's been more damaging to our dogs and to our relationships with dogs. It was suggested that people put a lot of pressure, dog owners put pressure on dogs that behave that way, pressure them, intimidate them, dominate them in order to correct the behavior. So unfortunately, TV shows are still promoting it. They're a little behind their times. It's not related to dominance. It's maybe related to insecurities in dogs, or their belief that there's not enough food to go around. So if you go to a restaurant, you order your food, you would like to enjoy it without having other people put their fingers in your plate or to stare you while you're eating. So you are entitled to enjoy your food while you're eating, and I think the same goes for dogs. They're entitled to enjoy their bone or kibbles or treats or whatever it is that's of value to them.
This is a great thing to give to dogs to play with. They get to spend some energy. Use up some of their energy, and they get to use their brain. And it tires them out. It's a great way of feeding your dog.
The way to deal with that is not to intimidate the dog, to hit the dog, to pressure the dog, to pin them down to the ground. And so now your dog doesn't even trust you anymore because you lost your control. You were unpredictable, and you hurt your dog potentially if you force your dog to behave a certain way when they didn't want to, instead of making it a rewarding behavior. Now, if this food possession issue was towards you as the dog owner, then there's things we can do about it. A positive reinforcement training, reward-based training, is the best way, best method to treat these behavioral issues. You need to consult with a local positive reinforcement dog trainer, professional dog trainer, who can come in and explain the situation, to observe what's going on in the home environment, observe your relationship with your dog, and vice versa. Your trainer will give you advice that's just custom made around your dog's behavior, your dog's, and your lifestyle, so that it will work for you. There's no one size fits all when it comes to dogs. Every dog owner out there wants to do the right thing. It's just that sometimes they've been misinformed by the wrong trainers, or TV stars who call themselves trainers. You can get help. It's never too late. And dogs learn quickly, and you will enjoy that time. You will be amazed how much more you'll actually like your dog. And you'll enjoy working with your dog when you see how quickly they respond. If you follow the right instructions given by the right trainer, you'll see results fast enough. It's a valuable relationship. It's very precious. So it is worth it to spend a month or two, or even more. And sometimes people spend a year working on one problem behavior. And then when it goes away, it is so rewarding. And your relationship is 100 times more valuable and stronger with your dog, and so it's really a beautiful thing.